Be careful what you wish for. You just might get it. Tonight we are answering the question of, what exactly are the jinn? We have all heard the old saying, be careful what you wish for, you just might get it. Well, who are granting these three wishes anyway? And where did this mythology originate? Remember I Dream of Jeannie? I Dream of Jeannie was a sitcom starring Barbara Eden. She was a 2,000-year-old genie, and Larry Hagman, well, this was before he was JR, was an astronaut who becomes her master. She falls deeply in love with him, and eventually, thank goodness, they do get married. And the show originally aired in 1965. Now, I totally love this show. It ran for 5 seasons, and it produced 130 episodes. I love the main character, Jeannie, of course, but I also loved her mother, Esmeralda, and her evil twin sister, Sabrina. I seem to always love the villain, as most of us do. Something primal about us humans, I suppose. Now, as far as I Dream of Jeannie, the pilot episode was called The Lady in the Bottle. Astronaut Captain Tony Nelson, Air Force, is on a space flight when his one-manned capsule Stardust One comes down far from the planned recovery area near a deserted island in the South Pacific. On the beach, Tony notices a strange bottle that rolls by itself. When he rubs it after removing the stopper, smoke starts shooting out of it, and a non-English-speaking female genie materializes and kisses Tony on the lip, shocking him. They cannot understand each other until Tony expresses his wish that Genie could speak English, which she then does. Then, per his instructions, she blinks and causes a recovery helicopter to show up to rescue Tony. He is so grateful he tells her she is free. But Jeannie, who has already fallen in love with him at first sight after being trapped for 2,000 years, re-enters her bottles and rolled into Tony's duffel bag so she can accompany him back home. And the rest, as they say, is her story. Now, do you remember Aladdin? Aladdin is a 1992 animated musical fantasy produced by Walt Disney Feature Animation and released by Walt Disney Pictures. Aladdin is the 31st animated feature in the Walt Disney Animated Classic series and was part of the Disney film era known as the Disney Renaissance. And as you remember, the famous genie in this story was voiced by the late great Robin Williams. It's a beautiful story, just like I Dream of Jeannie, a beautiful love story. And I don't know if any of you guys have watched Wishmaster, then you would find that that particular story was not exactly as loving and beautiful as the Disney story and as the NBC sitcom. So what are the jinn? These stories are based on an Islamic entity called the jinn. Jinn has also been romanized as D-J-I-N-N or jinn and angelicized in Christian mythology as genies. But basically, their term really is more akin to demons. Demons are supernatural creatures in early Arabic and later Islamic mythology and theology. An individual member of the jinn is called genie. They are mentioned frequently in the Quran and other Islamic texts and inhabit our world. The Quran says that the jinn are made of smokeless and scorching fire, but are physical in nature, being able to interact in a tactile manner with humans and objects, in other words, on our reality plane. The jinn, humans, and angels make up the 3 known sapient or intelligent or self-aware creations of God. Like human beings, the jinn can be good, they can be evil, or they can be neutrally benevolent, and hence have free will, like humans. The shaitan jinn are akin to demons in Christian mythology. But the jinn are not angels, and the Quran draws a clear distinction between the 2 creations. Archaeological evidence found in northwestern Arabia seems to indicate the worship of jinn, or at least the tributary status. Hundreds of years before Islam, an Aramaic encryption from Beth Fazil near Palmyra pays tribute to the Genii, the good and rewarding gods, and it has been argued that the term is related to the Arabic jinn. Numerous mentions of jinn in the Quran and testimony of both pre-Islamic and Islamic literature indicate that the belief in spirit was prominent in the pre-Islamic religion. However, there is evidence that the word jinn is derived from the Aramaic, where it was used by Christians to designate pagan gods reduced to the status of demons. And this was introduced into the Arabic folklore only in the late pre-Islamic era. Julius Wellhausen has observed that such spirits were thought to inhabit desolate, dingy, and dark places that they were feared. One had to protect oneself from them, but they were not the objects of true cult. So this is why they are made very similar to the term demons. In Islamic theology, jinn are said to be creatures with free will, made from smokeless fire by God, as humans were made from clay, among other things. According to the Quran, jinn have free will, and Iblis abused this freedom in front of God by refusing to bow to Adam when God ordered angels and jinn to do so. For disobeying God, Iblis was expelled from paradise and called Shaitan, or Satan. Jinn are frequently mentioned in the Quran. The Quran also mentions that Muhammad was sent as a prophet to both humanity and the jinn, and that prophets and messengers were sent to both communities. So it's beginning to look like that the jinn and humans occupy the same world. Like humans, jinn will also be judged on the day of judgment and will be sent to paradise or to hell according to their deeds. The social organization of the jinn resembles that of humans. That is, they have kings, courts of law, weddings, and mourning rituals. One common belief in the Muslim belief is that there is 5 distinct orders of the jinn, and here they are. The first is the Marid, large and very imposing. The Marid are considered the most powerful tribe of the jinn. They are the classic genies of folklore, often portrayed as barrel-chested men with booming voices. Originally sea spirits, they are often associated with water. The next is the Efreet, intelligent and cunning. The Efreet are thought to live in complex societies similar to those of humans. They are said to prefer caves and underground dwellings. Though they are particularly demonic, they are portrayed as changeable in nature and capable of being pious and good. In the Quran, King Solomon is said to have had power over a tribe of Efreet who performed various tasks for him. The next set of jinn are called ghoul. This tribe of jinn has traveled north and west to become a common English language term for undead monster. This is pretty close to its original Arabic connotation. Ghouls are thought to be zombie-like jinn who haunt graveyards and prey on human flesh. They are strictly demonic and incapable of goodness, often portrayed as nocturnal. You know, just your typical zombie. You can see how pieces of the jinn culture and the mythology and ideology of it has been incorporated into the Western thriller and horror movies. The next type of jinn is Sila, talented shapeshifters who are more tolerant of human society than other tribes of jinn. Sila are most often portrayed as female, thought to be extremely intelligent. Sila are nonetheless the most rarely seen of all jinn and appear only sporadically in folklore. There is a speculation that the term Sila might be related to Seelie, a Middle English word for good fairy. This would make sense. A Seelie does not appear to correspond to an Arabic root pattern, the good fairy. So the term Seelie or Sila could probably be what has been termed like Tinkerbell. Tinkerbell in modern society would probably be a Sila. And the last and probably one of the most recognizable type of jinn outside of the first jinn, well, probably even more than the first jinn, which is the cultural genie that we all know and love, but the last one is the Vetila, the original vampires. Vetila are semi-malevolent spirits from ancient Indian folklore. They can possess human corpses and prevent them from decaying, and in so doing, trick human beings into believing that the Vetila is an ordinary person. However, the Vetila can also change shape at will. They are thought to be natural psychics, able to foretell the future and gain insight into the past, as well as read the thoughts of others. So the djinn, even though you may not know that much about what they are and why they are, they have been used in many parts of Western culture, movies, and stories, because they're very interesting, and maybe because of the five different types of them. Our main type is the genie that we see that grants you the three wishes, whether it be the horrific wishmaster, or whether it be the very benign I Dream of Genie, or the vampire. And there have been so many stories written about the vampire. So when you see a vampire, you watch I Dream of Genie, remember, it came out of an earlier story or mythology from Aramaic folklore. And as we all know, before Islam, before Christianity, Aramaic came from the time of Jesus, or at least the people who lived in the Arabic worlds of Bethlehem. So think about that. It's all about history, all about origins, and what we incorporate into our worlds, the stories that we tell our children, the stories that we watch on movies and in TV and all that, come from a much older world. And remember, the genies, or demons, as well as angels, have always been depicted as being very upset that God chose Adam to be his chosen people, aka humans, over the ones who were here long before us. And of course, we were made of clay, we were made of the earth, and embodied the spirit of God. And the spirit of God was encased in clay, aka our bodies. And we have the genie, or the jinn, and angels, who are spirit, and who have powers, and who are closer to God, and have been very pissed off and jealous of humans. So this is one of the reasons why, and we all know the famous story of Satan, the most beautiful one, the most beautiful and powerful and right-hand man of God, who was so upset with God for choosing humans over the angels, was punished. And, you know, it's kind of one of those things of, I'm not fired, you can't fire me because I quit. Situations where he comes to earth, he's fallen to earth, and then he has the people who are part of earth as well, are the demons who are here among us. So when you make a wish in the dark, or in your soul, you close your eyes, you make a wish, you wish upon a star, be careful, because someone probably doesn't like you very much, depending on their mood and how nice they are. Because remember, the jinn are very much like us, and so are angels. Angels have emotions, they have feelings, they both physical and spiritual feelings, just like we do. So whoever is listening at the time, whispering in your ear, the devil made me do it. Well, the devil may not have made you do it. Maybe a jinn made you do it. Please comment below and what you feel about the jinn, and what are they exactly? Thank you so much for listening, and remember, be careful what you wish for. See you next time on Explaining the Unexplained.